the titanium dioxide, there are three different crystalline phase, right? Okay, so this is the butyl phase, butyl crystalline, and this is anatase one. And if you reducing of the this, okay, rutile and anatase, we can reducing of the band gap and observing the more visible light. Okay, so this is the rutile structure, right? And okay, and also they have a certain volume about 30. And this is the anatase phase, and they have about 2 times higher volume than the rutile, right? So compared with this, we try to find out new material, how to the making of the low band gap. Okay, so this is the science paper in the previous time. The science paper showing that, okay, this is the titanium dioxide material, and the science paper showing that to making of the black titanium dioxide, they are using, if you see that, the 20 bar hydrogen atmosphere, about 200 Celsius degree for 5 days. And then eventually they got, okay, this kind of the black titanium dioxide. This black titanium dioxide made of, like, the outside is the black and inside still maintaining of the crystalline phase, right? So what does it happen here? So this is the white titanium dioxide in crystalline phase after treatment with the hydrogen gas at 20 bar, very high pressure, and 200 Celsius degree, and making of disordered crystalline structure. So the main thing here is that the people notice that, okay, how can you making from the crystalline to amorphous phase? That is the most important issue. So the science paper showing that 20 bar hydrogen gas. Okay, so there are three different component here. Okay, pressure 20, and with hydrogen, and the temperature 200 Celsius degree. So if you can anyone find out the, instead of using a 20 bar, just normal atmosphere, like one atmosphere, and if you find out, okay, room temperature against 200 Celsius degree and without hydrogen, if you someone change of the titanium dioxide, white titanium dioxide at the room temperature and the solution process and without any high pressure, that will be the most desirable. And if you can find out, that will be the best way. So the science paper, they showing that they made it the black one based on the hydrogen condition from the 4 plus titanium to 3 plus. So this is the evidence from the XPS, and they check with the platinum dot one, giving about 10 millimolar hour, 10 millimolar day generation of the hydrogen gas. So this is the, at the moment, the world best to make of the black titanium dioxide. Okay, fortunately, we found out new reagent, which can doing a solution process and also room temperature without any hydrogen gas. So by using a new reagent, which is lithium ethylene diamine, usually lithium ethylene diamine, known as a Birch reduction reaction, can giving a electrolyte, which electron rich here. So through the the reaction is the, okay, this is known as a, the combustion agar one, P25. The P25 has a consisting of 70% anatide phase and 30% rutile phase, right? So the, our reagent, which is lithium EDA, can selectively reducing changing of the rutile phase only. So this is the new material at the room temperature, the solution process. So if you treatment with the starting material with anatase, with the lithium EDA, did not change. But if you only 100% rutile phase, they making of the black one. And if you have a P25, which is a question of 70% and 30% rutile, giving a blue color. So the making of the blue color, this is the first time in the world. And then we try to figure out, right? We showing that this is the right compound by using a characterization and many different analysis. So what happened here? So like what I said, the P25 have two different phase, has a which is 70% anatide phase and 30% rutile phase. If you treatment with our lithium EDA, right, only the anatide phase did not change, but the rutile phase is making a disorder like this. So selective change of the from the TEM showing that the we found out the rutile only changed the into the amorphous phase, and the blue giving up only rutile, which is the P25. Okay, so this is the if you treatment of the only the rutile phase making of the from the crystalline to the amorphous phase. This amorphous phase giving a blue color, blue emission, which means that they observing the light, the visual light. This is the another evidence from the XRD. XRD showing that also the rutile phase changed, and anatase phase did not change. Which is the and also. The, because of the change of the amorphous phase surface, the surface area, bead area, really increased. And also, the experience showing that there is a titanium silicate plus, which means that indicating of the reduced of the from the Ti 4 plus to Ti 3 plus. And oxygen also increases, which means that after treatment of the lithium EDA, the surface of the blue and black giving up the oxygen is hydroxy group here, attached here. Okay, and also this is the rutile giving up hydrogen portion is increases. Okay, and this is NMR showing the OH groups here also. So through the our characterization, and also this is the very very characteristic observance here. Usually the TiO2, the UV visible, right, only observing the UV zone from the 200 to 400 wavelengths, but from the visible region 480 nanometer, it did not observe. That is the usual, the TiO2. But with our treatment, reducing agent, which is lithium EDA, the black one observing the visible light up to the IR, and blue one, the intensity of the observance, okay, less than the black one, but observance also happened here. Visual light. What does it mean here? So we can do a something new application. Okay, so this is the We try to figure out for a band gap one, and then we try to understand and why it's happened. So through our treatment, there is a mid band gap coming out, and this action defect site giving up the low band gap can observe in the visual light. Okay, so like what I said. So we trying to producing the hydrogen gas from the water, which is known for a water splitting reaction. So the system has to be very, very simple for a real application. So this is the just one vessel and water and our product, which is the black one and blue one. This is the solar simulator. So when the solar simulator shines the light and the water producing the hydrogen gas and oxygen gas as well. Okay. So this is the near our system, you know. Okay. And we are using the sacrifice agent ethanol, methanol. And this is the result. Some reason we publishing the EES, the energy environmental science, and okay, and this one, if you look up this one, the hydrogen evolving reaction, okay, check with this one. So our blue TiO2 giving the best result, that even though the platinum P25, how much is good? Okay, and I'll return that later. Okay, and so this is the science paper. The science paper already shown that the okay, giving up this one, they made it 200 Celsius degree, 20 bar pressure with the hydrogen gas, and then they making of this material, which is a core shell structure, and with the 0.6 platinum, the doping one, giving up 10 millimore, which is the world best at the time. But our one, okay, our one made of room temperature processing without hydrogen, and the blue one, not the blue one. Blue one giving the best result, and this one, okay, 0.5 weight platinum dot giving about 14 millimore, which is the world best until now. And also without platinum doping, okay, about 4 millimore percent. So this is the world best, and also only the selectively making of the reducing it, this is the also one of the unique one. So how does it happen? Why this one giving the world best? Why this one giving up? Why the blue one is best than the red one? Because the question is that the observers, the visual light is that the black one giving a higher observance than the blue one. So based on the observance, we can estimate it. The black one the giving a best result. But the blue one giving the best result. Why? Why is that? So we're trying to figure out what happened here. So based on our time correlated single photon counting, so we did a low temperature one, and we measuring of the PL intensity. So the usual, right, this is the just without treatment, the P25 of the UV visible, the PL, right, it's showing that there are two, okay, peak here and here. And the normal time TiO2 also showing that here and here. But after treatment with our reducing agent, this peak disappeared. So what does it mean? It means that when the electron and force generating it, if there is something transporting layer, the better transporting layer, the reducing of this peer intensity, right? So that is the mechanism we proposed. So this is a science paper showing that core shell structure. The core is the crystalline phase. The outside is the amorphous phase. So when the light is coming and generating of the holes and electrons, this electron can making of the hydrogen from the water. When they make it, they have to interact with the water of the outer sphere. So this is the water, their mechanism. And our mechanism is we did selectively reducing it one side, only the luteal phase, not the anatase phase. So the anatase phase is the retaining it, and the luteal phase is amorphous. When the light is coming here, and then the recombination, the crystalline phase of the anatase phase, prevent the recombination to give a the good dissociation of the electron and holes, giving the best result. That is the analysis we proposed it. So that's the reason why this one giving the one the best one. Okay, so the first we are through this bonding and new materials, we trying to figure out for application. The first application, we trying to solve the environment problem. So as you know, this is the algae. This algae is in the river and also the off sea. Sea, there is algae is growing. When this algae is growing too much, the fishes are dying because of the competition of the consumption of oxygen, right? So the main idea is that we trying to apply for a near natural environment. What's the near natural environment? Our nature having a solar, right? So not only the UV irradiation. UV irradiation we can generate in the light. Laboratory, not the outside. So main point is that we're trying to using our solar system, and this solar system by using semiconducting material has to killing the algae. That is the main purpose here. So this one already I mentioned about when the titanium dioxide and with the light giving an electron and holes, and this electron and holes, especially electron giving a hydrogen divided reaction, this holes generate of the hydrogen radical or oxygen per radical. This hydrogen radical can killing the algae. So that is our principle. And so trying to understanding nearly this happened with the solar light with the hydrogen radical. We measuring it, the hydrogen radical from the electron spin resonance, ESR spectrum. So based on the UV irradiation, right, and UV irradiation, and also the solar irradiation, we compare 7 different materials. By with the treatment with the blue and black only be under the solar irradiation, giving us this hydroxy radical, which means that the, our product can killing the algae, and this is the, our the comparison. So this is the in the lab with the only UV light killing the one of the algae is about takes about 2 hours. With the solar light, okay, about the more than 2 hours, but it's completely killed. So this is the one of the our examples. Compared with the other normal titanium dioxide, only the our blue one in killing the reabsorbance of the near effective with killing the algae. Okay, so through the new finding, we're trying to making of the now we are working on the reduction of the carbon dioxide CO2, right? Really working, we trying to working with the solar system, not the only the UV light, right? That is the main point. And also really we trying to, right, commercial available making of the reduction of the CO2, that is the what we are working on. And also we are working on the reducing of the VOC and the bacteria and germs and fungus under the LED light, right? So the, because many people are in the here, right, it is not the solar light. So we're trying to make a new application with the low band gap, which has a black and titanium dioxide. This is our members we are working on. Okay, now we, our philosophy is that we're trying to focus on the finding out something, the breakthrough, and giving a benefit to our society through the something breakthrough research. Okay, thank you for your attention.